Well, now it's time to bring it on. We're going to get right back to it. I'm going to get my co-hosting hat back on. Can I do that?
We have a romance hat. Now let's get out of serious business. All right, go ahead.
I did dedicate my book to my future husband, by the way, though.
Oh, baby.
So, honey, if you're watching.
Well, I wish you the best.
I'm waiting for you.
Yeah, here on international television, and the offers will be coming in over the phone, over the transom. Go ahead.
Okay, Pat. Jan says, I have recently discovered that my pastor and his wife watch a show on cable that contains nudity. Even secular critics have called it pornographic. I've been unable to return to their Bible study since hearing this. Am I overreacting?
Yes, I think you are. You know, listen, the human body is not essentially nasty. I mean, God made us without clothes. And you look at that famous statue of David that's considered one of the masterpieces of the Renaissance. And here's David, and he doesn't have any clothes on at all. You've got the Venus de Milo and some of those others. You look at the Sistine Chapel. Adam has got no clothes on, and that's the famous artwork, you know, of God touching Adam. Well, Adam is naked because God didn't make us with clothes. So the body is not essentially pornographic, and I think to make it so is a mistake. It's what's in your mind. I don't know what your pastor is watching, what show it is, but maybe it's got some redeeming qualities, but I sure wouldn't turn him off just because he's watching a few clips of nudity on TV. I don't know what show you're talking about. Some of them are real nasty. I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, it depends on how pornographic it is, or if it's just
the human form per se isn't necessarily dirty. It's what our minds make it. Okay.
Amen. Diane writes, my son heard me talking in my sleep. He said I was saying evil things. He's convinced I have an evil spirit. I am a child of God, and I don't know what to say. This is breaking my heart. Do you have any suggestions?
Yeah, keep your son out of your bedroom while you sleep. That's your best suggestion.
Right? Yeah.
I tell you what, there's an unconscious that goes on in us, and there's stuff in there that we don't know about. And there's a collection of all the things you have heard, you've read. If you read most of the novels today, they're filled with nasty words. You watch a lot of television on cable particularly, it's filled with nasty words. If you're associating with people in the marketplace, you know, it's filled with, and so these things get into your subconscious, and so you're in an unconscious mode, and some of it comes out. That does not mean you're demon-possessed. Well, I'm sorry, that's all the time we've got, but thanks for this question.